Right, guys, I'm going to set up a different version of Dolphin. I don't know why that one's named weird. It's a normal version of Dolphin. But for some reason, it's not running Rogue Squadron because of Windows Update. But every time I use the Windows Update, I just get a flashing screen and Explorer don't work properly. Which I think I've sorted out a bug, but I'm not going to update again just yet. So this is it's a Kura Dolphin, it's a fork of it. It runs on the old x86 and 64-bit. Because the new version of Dolphin is only 64-bit. And this is such a good emulator, it's actually got a lot more effects in it. It's got like screen space, global illumination. Oh, it's got miles of different effects with upscaling, bicubic and stuff. So I'll show you how to set it up. So first of all, I'm gonna actually go to rename and copy, because I can never spell this right. So I'm gonna put it in here. So I'm gonna go to new folder. It's Ishiiruka Dolphin. And first of all, I'm gonna extract it. This is on quite a slow old hard drive, but and it plays pretty much all Wii games properly as well. I think the last version came out in 2021, I think. But it's a real big shame they didn't carry it on. They actually introduced the shader building before it's actually originally put in the Dolphin that you get now. So, right, that's done now. With any Dolphin emulator, if you make a text file and just call it portable, all settings will be saved within the folder. So text document, and name it portable. So it all gets saved within this folder now. So if I launch it, authorized Dolphin collect data, even though it's not, you know, valid anymore. I have included a lot of HD textures, and these are the HD textures that I bought with it. So I'm gonna, your HD textures go in user load textures, and we're just gonna move the folder into here. Right, while that's doing, right, first of all, I'm gonna set up my graphics. So I'm going to use DirectX 12, so it works really, really well on this. DirectX 9 occasionally crashes, and DirectX 11 is a bit slower than 12. And Vulkan is experimental, so it's not quite there yet on this one. But we can always flick between them later. Don't need any of this. Enable multi-threading, you want that. I'm not going to use full screen now, but it's here. So when you start a ROM, you can start it in full screen. Aspect ratio, I'm going to have on stretched, because I like the full screen effect. Don't like CRT 4.3 or anything like that. I'm gonna have my resolution on 4K. There we go to enhancements. And now this is your internal resolution. And it says at the bottom, you know, what it actually does. High resolution greatly improves visual quality. Will result in a size slightly larger than the window size, but yields fewer issues. So I'm going to go with 4K Ultra HD. Anti-aliasing, we're going to have on 4. And anisotropic filtering on 4. Don't need any more than that. Probably don't even need that 4K. Put a pixel light in, gives it better lighting effects. This reduces colour banding, and you have prone lighting as well. And here, like on Rogue Squadron, you can see the intensity of the lights from the ships on the cutscenes and things. You know, so you can increase them if you want. Amount of rim effect, glow effect. It's all trial and error, at least see what looks better per game. Right, other shaders. I'm going to have one hybrid. Filtering and curling, I'm going to keep as it is. I have got the other shaders here, but I'm actually not sure where to put them yet. So I'll have to figure that one out in a minute. Enhancements. This is for like your 3D effect, which is, you've even got the video 3D vision. I've still got some glasses somewhere. I picked them up from a car boot sale with the power pack and everything. I think I paid like £1.50, I don't even know if it works. I don't know where it is now. Right, post-processing. This has some really good ones. It has so many more than you get on the normal version. You've got Dolphin FX, FXA, high quality sampling, SSAO, screen space ambient occlusion, and SSGI, which is screen space global illumination, which I'm going to add. So you just choose what you want and go to add, and that's that done. Hacks, use full shader. This will speed up the shader compiling. Fuck, you know, get me words that marky. You can skip the FB access, but it's not worth it because you lose some effects in some games. But I'm going to have fast EFB access, and that should speed it up slightly. Advance, where you to load custom textures. This is the HD textures that we were transferring across into the folder a minute ago. So load custom textures. And you can actually cache them before the game starts, but you know, when you've got them full, it takes a long time to start. Then go to close. Right, now my textures have gone across into the Dolphin folder. You can either open them up and put them in one by one. I'm gonna have me Star Wars ones. Which is that one and that one, just to try in a minute. Here is, oh, I showed you the list earlier. All the ones I've got. Or you can just right click the raw file and say extract here. and it lets extract all of these. Once I finish this and zipped it up, then I'll delete these two so you can just extract which ones you want. You know, I hate WinRAR, it stops you doing anything else on your computer. There's probably a way around it, I just haven't looked yet. So now you have your extracted texture files, you just keep them exactly how they are. Right, now I'm going to go to config, enable dual core, you definitely want, enable cheats, I don't normally use cheats in any game until I've actually finished it. Right, untick use panic handlers. You get one little bug in the game and it can freeze the game and stop the emulator, when 99% of the time it actually will go past the bug. Right, then your audio on my emulators, they're always so bloody loud, so I'm going to turn it down. You know, if you have a low powered machine, then you'd want to put on audio stretching to match the game speed. Rogue Squadron is the only one that does have, not, don't think I've had any issues for a long time, but it can have problems. Right, GameCube, this is where you want your memory cards. This has, doesn't matter. Wii, I always keep things exactly the same. Right, this is your game paths. So I'm going to go to add. Mine is in ROMs, which is F. ROMs. Hard drive spinning up. GameCube. GameCube ROMs. Select folder. Then I've got my Wii ones separate, so I'm going to add again, back to F, back to ROMs, and Wii, then select folder. I'm not going to play with any of this, don't need to, never really tried it to see if it works or not, then go to close. And refresh, and all your games are here. You can also say we go down to Star Wars Rogue Squadron. You can right click, go to properties, and you can have like change all the different ones here as well. But this just overwrites what you've got on your actual main settings. So I'm just going to leave it all as it is. You can put in like cheats and patches for widescreen and things like that. Because you can go to edit and then you put in patches and stuff, you know, copy and paste them from the internet and save. Right, now we're going to set up the controller. On this one, it has to be an Xbox 360 controller. On the new versions of Dolphin, you can use like PS5 and that. So I'm going to go to configure. You just push a button on. Oh, might have if I choose the right one, won't it? Gamepad. Just go A, B, X, Y, Z. Up, down, left, right, up, down, Left. Right. Left. Right. Left. Right. Up. Down. Left. Right. You get a close. Or you can put in like normal and save. So that way you can have different configurations for different games. So we're gonna try like Star Wars first. The first time, I forgot about the actual shaders. This is your shader combination, so you know, once I've added these, it shouldn't stutter, hopefully. I just gotta figure out where to put them. So what I found, guys, found out where the shaders go. So I started the game and looked for where the shaders went. So user, shaders. Oh, wasn't in that one, was it? Oh, I just lost it again now. Save states. Load cache. There you go. Shaders UIDS. So I'm going to extract them all into there, which is going to take a long time. It's like 7 gig. So once this is doing, I will then come back to the video once they're all put in. Oh no, sorry, they were small. Don't worry, I'm being an absolute complete donut. Yeah, I thought it's me textures are that big. Right. See, it's only 267 megs, so I'm going having a spoon attack. Right, guys. I've also extracted, so I'm going to set up Mario Galaxy 1 and 2 in a minute on the controller. So I extracted those two HD textures as well. Right, so now all the shaders are on. I'm hoping that this will run better. Right, oh, enter for full screen. Just make sure it starts. And if we get any stuttering, it'll be right at the beginning. Just look around here, yeah. You always get a little bit there. Sometimes it's actually better with other shaders off on this game. As you can see, it's always really loud. And as you can see, the HD textures are working because it's here. Obviously messed up my controller somehow. But I haven't got right on it. Oh, that's better. Save. Yeah. And obviously this is works on 32-bit. And this is actually the hardest game with the next one that the actual emulator has to emulate. This took years before it even ran properly. About 5 or 6 years before it even started to run. Yeah, you gotta watch this bit. After we see what it runs like, then I'll set up Super Mario Galaxy. Like I say, it's just a shame that I didn't carry on with this one. Could be so much better than Dolphin. So if you put on bicubic upscaling, you get a lot of stutter on this. Super Mario Galaxy, and that's okay. And you get a bit of judder when it comes in a minute. And you get another bit just says the fighters are going down towards the space station. It'd probably work better without other shaders on this one. There you go. Press Shift F1, you can save it. That's save state, and F1 to load state. It's starting now. Oh, it didn't. Oh, there we go. I knew it would. Right, that one works fine, guys, so we'll stop that one. Yep. Right, now we'll set up for Super Mario Galaxy. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to go to graphics, enhancements, force lighting. I forgot to do that actually on the last one. Maximum detail. Post processing. On here, maybe two. No. I can't remember where it is. General. Where the hell are you two? You're upscaling filterings. is my marbles. Bloody are your teeth. Both press in time, no. Where the bollocks are you two? Right, I'm going to pause the video while I find it. Right guys, I found it. Texture scaling mode. By Cubic. This really does add a lot of depth to the game. Really, really nice. It's, and I forgot where it was. It's under graphics. Enhancements. Texture scaling mode. By Cubic. The only one I wouldn't use it on is actually the Rogue Squadrons. So now we're going to set up our controller. This one's totally different than, you know, what you normally got. So I got my gamepad. So I got my buttons. A, B, one, two, minus and plus is start and select. It doesn't really matter that much. So now you have your extension, which is Nunchuck, Super Mario Galaxy. I'm actually remembering this on the top of my head. So on this one you have WSAD, because you use that to walk. C, if I remember rightly, is crouch. And then you have X, Y, and this is like your spin. Do I set it up correctly? Right, so you don't need to tilt forward or anything like that. Close. Now you have your motion controls. You have your like IR to pick up your stars and stuff like that. Right guys, so your IR you want on your right analog stick. So you got up, down, left, right. And if you see down here, it bounces, once you let go, it bounces back to the center. When you're trying to pick up the stars, it's quite difficult. So what you want to have it on relative input. So now you can see it, the red one moving, and it will stay exactly where you left it. Instead of bouncing back to the middle. So, we're gonna Mario Galaxy. You know, I've done this so many times, that's why I remember it. You know, the easiest way to actually do it if you don't know how to set up the controls for the game is actually go into the game using your normal gamepad as best you can, and go into the options, and it should say what button does what, then you can come out and reconfigure for the game. So, and then go to save. Close. Close. So now I'm going to go start Super Mario Galaxy 2. Very occasionally, if it hasn't compiled anything, it will crash on the first go, but here's hoping. Mm-hmm. Come on. He didn't like that one, there you go. Right guys, I had that crash with Super Mario Galaxy 2. So I've gone to graphics and I've put it on DirectX 11. It don't work on Vulkan very well. It's really glitchy and horrible and crap. Crashed on 12. I just want to see if, you know, always had that problem. Always crashed it on DirectX 9. Don't know why. So we go DirectX 11. Everything's the same. And I've got SSGI still on. Vertex rounding, I think that helps 2D as well, yeah. I don't know what that is, force logical blending. Right, so now I'll stack it on DirectX 11. MIT, Super Mario Galaxy 2. This has got HD textures. See what relative input does? It stays exactly where you want it to. And occasionally I do get the spinning thingy set up wrong, so we'll have a look in a minute. So you can pick up the stars with them. Mr. Starry, you're like, fuck off waking me up, you bastard, let me go back to sleep. Right, let's see if me thingy works. Yeah. Obviously you might have to configure it because I'll be... Hello mate! Sorry, I'm in a pleb. So there you go guys, that's ISHIIRUKA DOLPHIN all set up. I might have to do it in two parts, so I don't know how much space I got left. One of my subscribers did have 2 terabits, he said, that I could use, but the thing is I got more than 2 terabits of ROMs and data and standalones and stuff on here. But it's such a good program, and obviously, you know, it works on x86-bit as well instead of just 64, and to be honest it runs pretty much as well as what the game is run now, but with better graphical options. Well, cheers guys, hope you enjoyed the video.